Linda was working for Town & Country magazine when her big break came in the form of a press invitation to meet the Rolling Stones.
And I took my camera, my little Pentax, and off I went to this, it was like at a yacht basin in New York City over on the West Side. And there were millions of journalists and photographers and people, because it was in the 60s when the Stones were very big. I was just standing there, taking it all in, when somebody came up and said, you'll be the only photographer on this boat. And I went, well, I said, but I'm not really that good a photographer, you know, I'm not really here as that. They didn't really listen to me, so they said, all the journalists are coming, but no, none of these photographers, just you. So I get on this boat and we go out to sea, and it's quite fun, and I start taking pictures, you know. Again, black and white film, which was, you know, I think, lucky.
So these were the pictures that certainly I've seen and I've printed, with Mick Jagger and the group. That was your first roll of film.
Yeah, well, first professional roll.
First professional roll.
Yeah.
Because you had done these photographs of the Rolling Stones, did that start you off with photographing all the other personalities of the day?
Well, several of the journalists, mainly the ones who were working for the teeny magazines, like 16 Magazine, Hullabaloo, all the kind of group magazines, got to know me because they liked the pictures. And they saw that I could get response from younger people rather than just, oh, here come the boring old news photographers. So they started ringing me up and saying, well, I'm doing a story as a journalist on such and such a group. Will you be the photographer? So I started getting actual work that paid that way. And also a lot of groups starting to see my work, asking if I'd take publicity shots for them. It was a very relaxed, I didn't have a studio, and it was just an atmosphere kind of thing. And I kept getting work and things grew, and Jan Wenner, a fellow who decided he was going to start a music newspaper.
What was that? What
came
was
over that and turned out to be Rolling Stone. He came over and said, well, somebody at Elektra told me that you had a lot of good pictures of musicians. Can I look through them? And I just had piles of photographs all over my apartment, because I'm not an ordered person, so they were just prints like that. So he went through them and he walked out with a stack like that. You know, Aretha Franklin, as you said, Cream, Hendrix, Stevie Winwood, I mean, everything. He said, and then he went off and started his newspaper.
So you were literally the first photographer for the Rolling Stones.
Then I kept doing stuff for Rolling Stones because I became a freelance photographer. I did stuff for Life magazine and Mademoiselle and Time. It became, I'm talking about a lot of years went by, and I was that peak when I thought, I better get an agent, this is too hard, you know. And I still didn't have a studio because I was well into natural light, natural people and natural light. So it just grew from there.